Eric and Laurel would like to take a moment to honor the loved ones who are no longer with us. They each give thanks for the memories, lessons, love that they have received. These loved ones have helped shape them into the individuals that they are today. Laurel and Eric know that these special people are watching down on them today with love and happiness, and this love is returned. If Laurel's godmother, Linda, will now share a reading with us.
Laurel and Eric asked me to read an invitation by Orion Mountain Group. It doesn't interest me what you do for a living. I want to know what you ache for and if you dare to dream of meeting your heart's longing. It doesn't interest me how old you are. I want to know if you will risk looking like a fool for love and for your dreams, for the adventure of being alive. It doesn't interest me what planets are squaring your moon. I want to know if you have touched the center of your own sorrow, if you've been opened by life's betrayals, or have become shriveled and closed from fear of further pain. I want to know if you can sit with pain, mine or your own, without moving to hide or fatal or fixing. I want to know if you can be with joy, mine or your own, if you can dance with wildness and let the ecstasy fill the tip without cautioning us to be careful, realistic, or to remember the limitations of being human. It doesn't interest me if the story you're telling me is true. I want to know if you can disappoint another to be true to yourself, if you can bear the accusation of betrayal and not betray your own soul. I want to know if you can be faithful and therefore be trustworthy. I want to know if you can see the beauty even when it's not pretty every day, and even if you can source your life from its presence. I want to know if you can live with failure, yours and mine, and still stand on the edge of a lake and shout to the silver of the moon, yes. It doesn't interest me to know where you live or how much money you have. I want to know if you can get up after the night of grief and despair, weary and bruised to the bone, and do what needs to be done for the children. It doesn't interest me to know who you are or how you came to be here. I want to know if you will stand in the center of the fire with me and not shrink back.
On my first date, Terry needs to teach you to skip rocks. To right now, I've always had strong feelings for love, happiness, and friendship with you. I will always strive to become a better man for you and our family. As our lives change and we grow old together, my love for you will grow as well. I'm yours forever.
Laurel, do you have any words you would like to share with Eric?
Stand here today, I feel I am in a place of complete happiness and peace, and you do that to me every day. The past 8 years have truly been an amazing adventure, and love is about learning who you are from one another. You've taught me how to live in the moment and to laugh in the face of obstacles and challenge. You hold my hand through everything and never let go or question my intentions. I appreciate your gentleness and your big heart and your open mind. I vow to always be there for you as we embark on our new chapter of life together. I'm yours always. I love you.
May we have the rings, please? Do you, Eric Daryl Carlton, do you, Laurel Leah Tung. Take Eric Daryl Carlton as your husband. Joining with him today in spirit, offering your friendship and loving care, you promise be your home. I am yours as long as I live. Place the ring. To me by the beautiful state of Washington and the county of Okanagan. I now pronounce that you are husband and wife.